Hi, I'm Johannes, product owner at Pessler, and in this video I want to explain you what experimental features are in PRTG, where you can find them, and what's the benefit for you if you are using them, and give us early feedback. Have fun! So maybe you already heard about experimental features in PRTG through a blog post or knowledge base article. If not, that's not a problem, because that's the reason why I'm talking to you right now. We introduced experimental features in the first version of PRTG in 2021, which is in numbers 21165. But why? Because we want to make the best product out in the market, and that's why we need your feedback and opinions to make it even better. But first, let's have a look on how currently feature wishes are introduced into PRTG. Of course, first through our knowledge base, where you can rank up the current feature requests and tell us your opinion about them. Second, our sales and pre-sales teams are always in contact with you or our beloved customers and collect your feedback and requirements. Third, if you open up a support ticket, you can always tell them your wishes and feature requests because they will forward it to responsible people. And last, you can always and anyways write us on the roadmap at pessler.com to tell us your wishes for our roadmap. And of course, we are always following the latest market trends and check out the latest technologies to introduce into PRTG to make it state-of-the-art monitoring. So that's how we collect the feedback, and let's see how we introduce it. So in the beginning, we start with a smaller feature set, then we introduce a new feature, which is a so-called, for example, beta sensor, and that's how we introduce experimental features. So what does a beta sensor means? It's just the first iteration of our sensor, but it's still fully working, but just misses some smaller features we want to have in the end. But we wanted to release it as early as possible to collect your feedback on it. Do we collect the right metrics? Are they useful? Any other wishes you have on them, or we need to introduce more features? That's what we want to hear for you, and that's why we release it as early as possible. But be assured, they are already working. They pass all quality gates when we ship them, so they are ready to use, but as I said, just missing some minor features. We keep beta sensors at least 3 versions in the product, where we continuously improve them release for release for release until we are happy with them and you give us the okay to release them. And then every customer can profit from a perfect solution out there. So now let's have a look into PRTG, how you can activate the experimental features and get your hands on the latest experimental sensors. So let's start right away activating experimental features in PRTG. First, we go to Setup. And then on the monitoring, you can now find the new section, experimental features, with the proper description. And then currently we have 2 sections here you can enable. First is beta sensors, and the second is the PowerShell security enhancement. But for this tutorial, we check just the beta sensors. So as I said, beta sensor means it's the first or one of the first versions of a new sensor, and we want to have early feedback from your side if we're delivering the thing you really need, or if it's already a thing you need, but how can we make it even better to fulfill your needs? So we enable the beta sensors. And this just means that now when you're gonna add new sensors in PRTG, you can now see the experimental ones. So here in our case, we have a backoff IPC system. And luckily, we have right now an experimental feature which adds a backoff IPC health sensor to PRTG. So let's check it out. And we go to the new Add Sensor dialog, and you can already see it here, but just for fun reasons. I search for backoff, and you can see here that we have the backoff one with the proper beta label, which means if you see a sensor in PRTG labeled as beta, it means it's an experimental sensor state. But as I said, they are already working. So we can edit now, no settings, we need to choose. But as you can see, we already have the channels there, the necessary information, and it runs. And that's now your chance to tell us what you think about the sensor. Does it what you need? Are the right metrics there? How is the settings page looking? Are you missing any crucial metrics you need? Or any other opinions about them? Please tell us your opinion and how we can make it even better. Because now we wait until 3 versions when we release a sensor from beta into new state, which means it's finally in the product and everyone can use it without activating experimental features. And that's how easy it is in the end to activate experimental features. And so please tell us your opinion and try them out as fast as possible. Thanks. I hope you really found this tutorial helpful. And if so, please give us a like or consider subscribing to our YouTube channel. Also, leave us a comment for feedback or any other topics. And if there are any questions, always ask us at support@pessler.com. Thanks for watching.